Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, we will be discussing about Reynolds number, the most important dimensionless number in fluid mechanics and water resource engineering. Reynolds number is basically a dimensionless number represented by the ratio of inertia force and viscous force. Mathematically, it can be represented as rho VL upon mu, where rho is the density of fluid V is the average velocity L is the characteristic length which will depend upon the type of flow characteristic length and mu is the coefficient of viscosity or viscosity of fluid. Now this Reynolds number, the most general form of equation or the formula is this one, and depending upon the type of flow it can be modified. This characteristic length will change depending upon the type of flow. For example, if we have a pipe flow, for pipe flow the Reynolds number is represented as rho V D upon mu, where D is the diameter of pipe, or the characteristic length in case of pipe flow is characteristic length is equal to the D or diameter of pipe. Generally, the Reynolds number is represented in this form in most of the resources, because Reynolds number is most prevalent in case of pipe flows. Now, if we are considering the case of open channel flow, then this characteristic length will change to R, where R is the hydraulic radius. R is equal to hydraulic radius, which hydraulic radius is the ratio of flow area and wetted parameter. Generally represented as A by P. So in case of open channel flow, the Reynolds number will be equal to rho VR upon mu. Similarly, the characteristic length will again change to diameter of particle in case of free fall. If suppose a particle is freely falling in a liquid, then this Reynolds number will be equal to rho VD upon mu, where D is the mean diameter of falling particle. D is the mean diameter of particle. So in this way, Reynolds number will, the formula for mathematical formulation for Reynolds number will change from one flow to other flow. This basic formula of Reynolds number can further be modified in terms of kinematic viscosity. How we can do that? So we can write Reynolds number is equal to VL by mu by rho. We have taken this density into denominator from numerator. Now this term mu by rho is known as kinematic viscosity, which is equal to mu by rho. That is kinematic viscosity. So in that case, we can represent the Reynolds number as VL by nu. So this is the basic formulation, mathematical formulation to calculate the Reynolds number depending upon the velocity, characteristic length and viscous properties of liquid. We can determine the Reynolds number in case of different type of flow, that is open channel flow or pipe flow or fall of particles, free fall of particles. Now let us move to the next characteristic, that is how Reynolds number is helpful to us in fluid mechanics. Firstly, it helps us to determine the type of flow, whether the flow is laminar, turbulent or in transition. That is determined based on the Reynolds number. For example, for pipe flow, if the Reynolds number is less than 2000, then it is considered to be, Reynolds number is less than 2000, then it is considered to be laminar flow. If the Reynolds number is in between 2000 to 4000, then it is transition flow. And if the Reynolds number is greater than 4000, it is considered as turbulent flow. Now this Reynolds number at which the flow starts changing from laminar flow to turbulent flow is known as critical Reynolds number. Now similarly for open channel flow, Reynolds number less than 500 represent the laminar flow. In between 500 to 1000, it represents transition flow. And finally, Reynolds number greater than 1000 represents the turbulent flow. Similarly, in case of free fall, Reynolds number greater than 1 is considered, less than 1 is considered as flow is laminar, otherwise it is in transition or turbulent. And in case of flow between parallel plates, Reynolds number less than 500 is considered as laminar flow. Now what is the benefit of knowing whether the flow is laminar or turbulent? We can, how it will benefit us in knowing this. So Reynolds number, when we talk about laminar flow, that means the flow is taking, streamlines are absolutely parallel and the streamlines or fluid particles are moving layer by layer. They are not crossing each other, they are parallel. However, if the flow is turbulent, the particle movement, the streamlines are haphazard and they do not have any orderly movement and they are crossing each other. So in case of turbulent flow, this type of streamlines are observed, while in case of laminar flow, this type of streamline pattern or flow pattern is observed. Based on these characteristics of flow, we can identify the rules or equations that will be applicable to this type of flow, that is laminar flow, and the other, the turbulent flow. So once we have used Reynolds number to identify whether the flow is laminar or turbulent, we can use this information further to decide which type of equation we are going to use. For example, the equation of motion of fluid particles, we have F net, net force acting on element of fluid in any direction, suppose x direction, that will be equal to gravitational force plus pressure force plus viscous force plus turbulent force. If the flow is laminar, that is Reynolds number is less than critical Reynolds number, then this turbulent force won't be there. So the equation will be simplified to, we can use this equation, gravitational force plus pressure force plus viscous force. In fact, this viscous force tries to dampen the turbulence, and it plays a major role in damping the turbulence. Even when the flow is laminar, there is tendency of fluid particles to move in haphazard way and create turbulence, but this viscous force stabilizes it and makes that dampens the turbulence. This characteristic of viscous force is known as viscous damping. Viscous damping. Now, this equation is the most common equation used in fluid mechanics and is known as Navier-Stokes equation. Or NS equation. Now this can be extended to all the direction. If we are considering this in x direction, then we have three set of equations in x, y and z directions. So these three equations can be solved to solve the problem. Similarly, if we consider this fluid as ideal fluid, this equation may further be simplified to F net is equal to gravitational force plus pressure force, because the viscosity of ideal fluid is considered to be zero. So this equation is known as, this equation is known as Euler's equation. Euler's equation. So in this way, determining the Reynolds number will help us to find which type of equation we are going to use for solving a particular problem. Now moving to the next application of Reynolds number. Once we have characterized that, we came to know that the flow is laminar or turbulent, we can identify the shear stress and the type of head loss we are going to experience. If suppose we are designing a pipeline or power supply system or water supply system for a locality, then we can see that everybody needs the water at good rate, that is the velocity should be enough or the flow rate should be enough so that they can quickly fill their containers or tanks, whatever they have in their houses. But the problem is that when we increase the velocity, Reynolds number is rho VL upon mu. So when we increase the velocity, Reynolds number will increase. If the Reynolds number increases beyond a certain limit, then the flow will change from laminar to the turbulent flow. So when there is a turbulent flow, there is greater head loss, because in laminar flow, head loss is proportional to the velocity, but in case of turbulent flow, head loss is approximately proportional to the square of velocity. Already the velocity in case of turbulent flow is much higher than that in laminar flow, and further the head loss is proportional to the square of that velocity. So we will have greater head loss in case the flow is turbulent. Further, this is because this head loss is more because the shear stress between the layers in case of laminar flow is much lower as compared to the turbulent flow. In turbulent flow, the shear stress between the layers of fluid is much higher, and therefore there is greater energy loss, एंड फर्दर दिस एक्सर्ट्स अ ग्रेटर प्रेशर ऑन द बाउंड्रीज ऑफ द पाइप सो मेंटेनिंग रेनॉल्ड नंबर इन सच अ वे दैट द हेड लॉस इज मिनिमाइज्ड इज द एसेंशियल रिक्वायरमेंट फॉर पावर फॉर वाटर डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन सिस्टम्स और इन इंडस्ट्रियल यूज इफ वी आर हैविंग वी आर सप्लाइंग फ्लूड फ्रॉम वन ऑयल और सम फ्लूड फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू अदर देन दिस हैज टू बी टेकन इन टू अकाउंट सो रेनॉल्ड नंबर कैन इजिली बी डिटर्मिंड बाय द मैथमेटिकल फॉर्मूलाज रिप्रेजेंटेड ऑलरेडी रिप्रेजेंटेड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ रो वी एल अपॉन म्यू बट इफ यू वॉन्ट टू फिजिकली see this type of flow pattern inside the pipe then we have to move to the experimental setup by known as Reynold experiment so in that case what we can see that suppose we are having this container Reynold experiment apparatus we are having a die here and there is opening in this section and here we have the die in this and here water is filled and this is the pipe transparent pipe which is connected to a collecting tank here so when there is a wall here when we will open the wall and slowly increase the velocity what will happen initially when the velocity is low we will see the die will move in a straight line in this manner so the flow here is laminar suddenly when gradually when we will increase the velocity then what will happen this die will start breaking when this die will start breaking it represents that the flow is changing is in transition and is moving towards turbulent flow further when we increase velocity to a higher range then this die will break and will be in haphazard motion all over the pipe so in this way we can determine that this type of flow or the flow pattern streamlines will be parallel in case of laminar flow and in case of turbulent flow they won't be parallel to each other now in this experiment we have seen that this type of pattern will occur for each pattern we can determine the Reynold number through the formula rho vd upon mu Density of fluid we already know, viscosity we know, diameter of the pipe will be given. We need to determine the velocity. For determining the velocity, this is the collecting tank with piezometer connected here. We can read the reading of piezometer. Suppose for 10 mm rise, the time taken for 10 mm rise in this collecting tank will be noted and the area of say this rise is h so the area of tank is known so we can determine the volume of water collected volume of water collected will be area into height then we can determine the discharge will be volume upon time so it will be equal to a into h upon time in this way we can determine the discharge q then we know that the velocity is q by area discharge by area so here we need to determine the velocity average velocity in this pipe so we will take the area of this pipe so that will be equal to q upon pi by 4 d square in this way we can determine the velocity for each flow pattern and by using this velocity in this equation again, we can determine the Reynolds number for each of the case. And we will see that for Reynolds number less than 2000, we have the flow pattern is parallel flow pattern. And in case Reynolds number exceed 4000, then there will be hazard moment in the fluid particles. So in this way, we can determine this Reynolds number in laboratory also. Thank you for watching our video. Please subscribe to our channel.